On this episode of The Art of Seeing, we go on a hike up into the mountains, Bell Canyon Reservoir, with Christina as my hiking buddy and model. And we find some cool spots, and we talk about some photo tips, and now let's begin. All right, look at that. Camera having trouble. So, we're going to do another episode of The Art of Seeing. What is The Art of Seeing? This is Christina.
Hi.
She's going to be the friend and model for the day.
Yes.
Okay, the art of seeing is just kind of being able to imagine if you were taking pictures, what's a good spot here and there. And we're going to do that on a hike up Bell Canyon.
Sweet.
Okay, so I looked over there while I was talking to you and I'm like, that's a cool spot. Because it's a little area where you could get to easy. Someone could be in there up towards the front because you want distance behind them. And look at that. Yeah, we don't need it on this case. They can just imagine it. They could see it with their eyes.
I'm imagining like a hobbit or something.
Hey, we'll do portraits and landscapes because it's going to be pretty cool up there. So we got a little bit of dusting of snow on the top up there. So making this peak look at least decent, you know. So that's cool. And then we got some cool muted colors. Hey, turn around for a second. Don't turn around. So look right there. You get a little bit of the trail. I don't know. Okay, we'll find something really cool. I'll show you guys next. But join us on this hike. In this episode, we will hike Bell's Canyon. Have a good announcer voice? Someone once told me that I should announce at like professional sports games. Well, let's be honest. It was just one person that said that. But I thought that was fun. Ladies and gentlemen, now up to bat, Christina! Up to bat, woohoo!
I'm thinking maybe you should be like a classic rock.
Classic rock announcer?
Yeah.
This is Jarvie in the morning at 105.5. Blah, blah, blah. Shout out to Scotland. Boom. All right. All right. So you got the little clouds just laying there, someone once told me. She spotted it. She spotted it. Get a little more of a zoom in there because the foreground, not that great, but it works as a good frame for the mountain. So if you went like that, a little bit more snow would make that mountain a little bit better. And better clouds that aren't just gray. That's it. So I'll give you a look-see of what we're seeing up top in Sandy, Utah. Ladies and gentlemen, Sandy, Utah. Let's hear it for Sandy, Utah. Yeah. All right, we found a good spot for a little portrait or just non-portrait as well. She's a little tall though, so being right next to that tree is gonna bunch you in a little bit too much. So how do we get you down just a little bit? Oh, if you go over to the side, yeah, that kind of, right there, yeah. Now you're next to that other one. Well, she could get rid of it, but, or go back further. There. So, frame, natural frame. Still a little bit of fall colors. Nice, the blue, I think that kind of is fun. Smile, click, smile. Oh, good job. Look, there's still some fall. You can get some real good close-ups of someone. With just a nice little fall background. Even though that's not fall, this little area is. Alright. I bet that's a really good spot down there. Let's go check it. It's nice. I mean, not like... Well, you got too much like crap right here and here. Otherwise you get a tripod or put it right here. Get a long exposure. That's pretty cool, but being up here in the fall would be a lot better. But you know what you can do when you're up on this bridge and there's stuff down there, is you can tell people to go stand or sit down there. Oh, she's even gonna do it. Look at that. And then you get like an upshot here. And it's nice. You got the green there, that sort of thing. Green and water. So it's a little bright. Let me darken this. There we go. So we're just bringing you all the greatest hits. And we've got friends coming on the trail. And I don't have my hat on because it was too hot. 45 degrees. Way too hot to hike. Right? All right. Christina pointed out something. So Christina is seeing things. Seeing things with Jarvie. The art of seeing. So the roots are interesting. So how do you get a picture with it? Because so much of the background loses interest or depth, you can get down a little bit lower, maybe have them sitting, or use this natural frame. But the sky, you gotta get up a little higher, because the sky is not gonna be awesome. Framing, it's actually gonna be pretty challenging, but I see the appeal of the roots. I really do. But I don't have a ton of how, it would take me a while. So some places, you're just like, hey, stand on that rock right there. You'll be above the horizon if I go down lower. And like, I see it right away. And I know how to make that a decent picture. And if I go down a little bit lower, those mountains, or the houses disappear when they're on that rock and they're standing there. And I don't know, like, it's not an exceptional picture, but it's good and it's easy and it's fast. When you see this, you're like, that is cool. That is awesome. That's much more interesting than that, but this is much more difficult than something I'm just like, boom, 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 I know how to do it. But over here, I would have to take quite a few pictures. I'd have you like on maybe that route right there, like sitting, no, the other one maybe, and looking off to the side. And I'd have to get down lower so that I get more of the roots. Maybe that's an awkward branch to sit on. See, it's just gonna take a few more things. So I will take the challenge from anyone.
Telling me,
oh, let's try this. I take the challenges. Oh, well, this is a lot better, huh? Mm-hmm. This is where you come to this side. And the sky looks pretty cool from this direction. You could have them almost off on this trail. She's looking another spot. She's into it. She's like, she used to do a lot of art too. So you could have them right here and just kind of balance this cool tree with someone right here in this open area or something over there. But like I said, sometimes it's good to be pushed and not just do the easy ones though. That is true. So. What do you have against white trees? It can mingle. They don't believe in segregation up here. That is actually pretty cool for just like a normal landscape shot. Darken it up a little. And then afterwards, maybe you could brighten it up and have that kind of eerie, bright, happy tree in the midst of the death.
He's getting Bob Ross on him.
Yeah. Just a little happy tree right there. Just a little, and not too much of that sky. I could see putting it right there because it's got a little cool, eerie section. That's about how I'd frame it. Maybe a little bit down like that. So you get a little bit of this color leading to that, and I don't know. Actually, kind of want to take that shot now, but shoot it darker so that this stands out. Actually, did take a picture over here. Now we're gonna do video. So down like this, look at the difference between this and that. And when she puts her hand on the hip and power stances it. Look at that.
What's,
yeah,
power stance?
I don't know. It's whatever you want
it
to be. You work out.
Well, I already do that.
Okay. Well, then there you're good to go. Bye, happy tree. I took a picture. Worthy, but look what Christina found. Oh, if you got real low like this with the cell phone, even that's pretty cool. Maybe I will. Folks, these are all spots seen by Christina. All the stuff, the tosal, the, what is it called? Snake grass. You know what you want to do with this? Get a cell phone out and get some cool pictures of this. Now, I think you may need the compression of a DSLR. It doesn't look as good with the cell phone, actually. But you need some that are just kind of, yeah, like this. Now, cell phone's not as cool. Oh, that's pretty good. I could be, we're onto something. I think right there, that's what you want. See what we're talking about with the deeper background? So it gets blurry. That's what you want. So you have to search around to find a few of these.
There's a funky one right there.
Funky? Called Medina?
Yes.
See, get up real close though, because that's, everything's in focus.
What if you take the format and flip it that way?
Oh, then they couldn't see because it's a video.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they'd get mad at me. You'd get mad at me. All right, but these are cool. So that you can do it with the cell phone. You can. Here's another cool little thing. If we darken it up, look at.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah? This one's drawing too much attention, so let's just get it out of there. Go down lower, then you've got these going into the corners. That's pretty cool. And then a little bit less, I don't know. Oh, that's pretty good. I like that. So we're doing more than just portraits. How many people watch these for the portrait tips, and how many watch it hoping just to get general ones, I guess, or landscape even. So, all right. The lake is having issues with no water. Imagine this with me. You have to imagine a DSLR or some sort of camera with a really good zoom. Not all this. You want to put them way back in that opening because it's kind of lit up. Go a little bit down and then kind of zoom in. And that's the kind of thing that'd be kind of cool. Maybe we could even do this with a cell phone. What do you think? I bet we could.
It'd be a nightmare for long hair, though.
With all you have long hair?
Yeah, with all of these things.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, the burr.
I kind of got long hair now, too. What do you guys think?
Yep.
What do you think? Oh, I got burrs on my shirt. Yeah. Speaking of that.
It.
Dang it. Oh, wow. Yeah, these are the burr ones. Ooh, yuck. Another landscape. Well, I mean, it could be a portrait pretty easily if you put someone, like, right there. Because you don't want to miss that part of the trail. So that's why you put them on this side. But that's pretty cool. You got a certain look at this time of the year. You get down low too. How low can you go? Oh, and all these scrub oak are pretty fun for pictures. They are pretty fun. Oh, look at that. She looks off to the left. Good stuff. Just walking through the forest. Hey, so here's today's question brought to you by Christina. Do you want to ask it, Christina, your question? And get 1,000 answers on
my
YouTube?
Amazing voice today.
5 answers on YouTube. Yeah, she's kind of sick. Let's hear it.
Hey, how do you overcome discouragement?
How do you overcome discouragement? I used a photography example. I talked about some other things, but then I used a photography example to talk about life. So, since this is somewhat, but first, that's a great backdrop right there, because not it itself, but it blurred out in the background like this, right? So here's the person, focus there, and it's just kind of a nice background, but a little compression, not a wide angle like this. There's our person, but more zoomed in. Discouragement. So my example, to not give away all of my tricks. Is that sometimes in photography...
I love this area. Sorry. Ooh,
yes.
Squirrel.
Squirrel. This is very nice. And I love when you're up top, able to kind of shoot down, and there's framing and depth.
Look at the way that branch goes over the top.
Yep. So, okay. So I would do photo shoots, maybe like weddings, right? And sometimes I'd get discouraged, maybe because it's a long day, and I get discouraged a lot. Well, like, I'm more susceptible to discouragement when I'm tired, which is interesting. Where is that trail? Is it just that right there? Cool. We'll take this little shortcut.
Yeah, it just goes right up.
It's right up there. Okay. So that's when I'm a little more susceptible to discouragement. So sometimes just... Oh, it's just a little thing right here.
Okay.
Just sleeping will help me to not... feel as much. But let's take that photography example. Sometimes I'm like, I'm not doing a good job. I get anxious because I'm like, is this going to work out? Are these pictures working out? I rely on experience and that kind of like faith and hope, that sort of thing. Like, you're like, look, I've done like 50 of these and they've all worked out. I've taken some good pictures. So why am I feeling this way? And I'm able to tell myself, like, this is just a feeling. It's not reality. And so I'm just like, it's going to be fine. So I'm able to kind of rely on that. Maybe that's a personality trait, or maybe that's just kind of starting off small, getting good experience. And when it becomes like big time, it's like, hey, you're paying you a lot, or this is a big deal. Then you have that moment, because if you just start with the big deal, then that's kind of harder to overcome. I'm a little out of breath. But I'll show you this. So just getting out there, get some experience, and say, like, I got this. Oh, I think that really good meadow is up this part, right?
I think so.
Yeah, look at that. This is good for landscape. Do you know what I'm talking about? Someone else in the comments explain it more beautifully for me, because I'm walking short on air. I don't know what it is. Look at that. So if I get out there and I'm like, ah, these pictures aren't good, you just keep working hard and you just tell yourself it's gonna work out fine. There may be 1500 pictures that suck, but I took 2000 and 500 is a freaking lot for a wedding. So that's good. You got 500 good shots. Even if there's 1500 that kind of didn't work out. Look at that. That's pretty too. Framing. Natural borders. You know what I like. Okay, we got to show you this little meadow. Boom. I don't know if I like this on the side or to open up like that. Put someone right here. Put someone in the trail leading towards them. Come back when their skies are a little bit more interesting. This is going to be a long video, huh?
Maybe.
Maybe. Maybe. Give them one rah-rah thing about discouragement.
Oh, what do you mean? Like something that I do?
Yeah.
I find like, something to look forward to, even if it's something small.
Something to look forward to.
I plan something, whether it's, you know, I'm going to get
trip
up.
To Europe. You're well, like,
for those
I can't give up now.
For those of us
I've got to go to Italy.
Financially challenged, you know. Oh. I have to go with more short term.
A trip to Italian food.
Absolutely. Cinnamon, chocolate covered cinnamon bears.
What? No. Not you too.
Yeah, it is. It's a bad thing. No, like, If I know that there's gonna be like the first snow, I'll get myself all psyched up about it, and then I'll be thinking about it,
yeah.
And I'll plan what I'm gonna see and how it's gonna feel. I'll think yeah. about all that, and that's kind of a small thing, but.
And then make sure that you're always having fun on these little ventures, so that you don't look forward to it and go, oh crap, I always suck at these things. Wait, does that make sense? I should have just left it out what you said.
Adventures?
I'm good at adventures.
How can somebody suck at an adventure?
I don't know. Look at that. That's a cool video. By the way, still using the Note 7. Hasn't blown up on me. I probably should get rid of that this weekend with some sort of Black Friday sale or something. I need to get a new phone because I can't travel with this one in the airplanes. But there's just nothing as good as the Note 7. Really, nothing. Nothing beats it. Which is sad. I wish something did, because I can't use it anymore. More framing. Here's a little tip. Even on your cell phone like this, when everything's kind of dark, these branches are dark, trail's dark, you know, that sort of thing, the camera wants to light up. So find the quick function to darken it down so that she's lit up correctly and let this remain moody. And I wouldn't get those mountains. Something like this. Framing. You know what I'm talking about. Natural borders. Boom. Good job. I did actually take a picture, not just do this for video. Okay, people. These are all coming to you straight from Christina. She's heavy into this game on seeing spot the spot. She found this, and the thing about it is it gives a little frame to that mountain. The trees are in the clouds coming through are cool, but you got a bottom border with these kind of cool muted colors. Only thing you need is these clouds to look a little bit better, then it would be awesome. And since it is kind of raining, everything is much more vibrant. Did you know that? She yeah. actually said that earlier.
You don't have to pump up the saturation.
You don't have to pump it up.
Nope.
Pump it up. Christina found what she really wanted to photograph, which is bright red berries. So she's getting right up there. She found the shot. You guys getting excited? Now you guys want to go out and see things? See things with Jarvie? Come along. Ladies and gentlemen, come along on an adventure with Jarvie. Just $9.95. Like $995? Just kidding. Okay, so if we come over here, that's just a nice little mountain stream. All right, folks, that's it. Thanks, Christina. This is a crazy picture. I'm sure you'll love that I posted it. And thanks for finding some cool, interesting spots to photograph. I hope everyone enjoyed the art of seeing and practiced some, you know, visualizations of good portrait pictures and some fun landscapes. And get out there, go on a hike, take yourself.